Our focus tonight on sustainability issues looks at how the city of Phoenix is working to run its fleet of garbage trucks on natural gas. Here to tell us about it is John Trujillo, acting director of the Phoenix Public Works Department. Thank you so much for joining us tonight.
Thank you.
Let's start with defining terms here. What is CNG fuel?
Well, there's different types of fuel, but CNG fuel is a compressed natural gas that we use, and we compress it at on site and use it to fuel our current garbage trucks that we have right now, which is currently six.
So are garbage trucks the only city vehicles right now with this, or are there other city vehicles?
There's other city vehicles that are utilizing compressed natural gas, but it's mostly smaller equipment, smaller vehicles, cars, trucks, that sort of thing. But this is more of a heavier equipment that really we haven't done before to this extent. We have practiced and done some, which is we used LNG, and now we've tried CNG, and we feel that the CNG fuel is the best way for us to go.
Can power a big old garbage truck,
yes,
huh?
Yes, it can.
And those arms that go up and down and
yes, they do. Yeah, yes.
Let's take a look. We have some video now of a garbage truck actually being fueled. Tell us what goes, I mean, it just looks like it's the same old thing as when you go to a gas station.
Yes, and you wouldn't notice the difference, but basically, you know, the driver just gets out and gets a hose. When he gets back from his route, he plugs it in. And it starts fueling while he's off site. So it's an overnight process.
Okay, when so it takes a while truck. Then, yeah.
Yes, it's about a 6 to 10 hour process.
And those gauges basically show how much is being compressed. And when you hit a certain spot, knock it off.
It stops automatically. When they come back to work in the morning, they pull it off and they go on their route.
Were these diesel vehicles before?
No, they were not. So we're not retrofitting the equipment. So as the equipment, the old equipment, goes away, we bring in the newer equipment we're buying is for compressed natural gas technology.
Okay, because I was wondering kind of what it replaced and the cost there from what it was to what it is.
Right, and it is a higher cost to purchase CNG garbage trucks versus the regular diesel trucks. However, the cost of fuels compared between diesel and CNG, there's a big gap between the two. So CNG currently is approximately $1.50 per gallon versus $3.50 per gallon for diesel.
Interesting. And I've heard CNG described as being an economically stable fuel. Is that what you're talking about there?
Yes. Yes, it is. And there's others, too. It is back in 2000, CNG and diesel were equal in cost. But between 2000 and now, there's been a big spike between diesel and CNG has not spiked as much. So it's a more stable fuel that you can project, and it's easier to budget for compared to diesel.
Do we know why it hasn't spiked?
I think it's because it's produced here domestically, so it's not dependent on oil prices on a global level, and this is based on natural gas prices on our local national level.
Yeah, we've seen the state dabble, for better or worse at times, in compressed natural gas vehicles and trying to promote that particular operation. But when it comes to the city and when it comes to garbage trucks, are there concerns with that kind of heavy machinery on natural gas?
No, we've been testing alternative fuels since 1994. And so we've done CNG in the past. It hasn't worked well for us. The technology wasn't quite there yet. And then we've tried liquefied natural gas, mm-hmm. and it didn't quite work. And now the technology has caught up. And we've been testing CNG in our garbage trucks for the last year, and it's worked very well for us to this point.
Are there plans to switch other and or more city vehicles to CNG?
Yes, there are. We will, by the end of this year, we will have 20% of our garbage trucks with compressed natural gas, and by 2015, 50% of our garbage trucks will be fueled by compressed natural gas, which we feel will be the largest municipal garbage trucks that'll be fueled by compressed natural gas in the nation.
I was going to ask, was this modeled after other cities? Why was the push for CNG at this particular time?
Well, we've been doing this, and other cities are using liquefied natural gas. A lot of them are going to compressed natural gas. A lot of it because it's a more stable fuel, and it's more readily available, and we have the infrastructure in place for us to do this now.
And it's a little quieter, isn't it?
It's a lot quieter. So as you realize, a lot of our residents put out their garbage based on the sound of a garbage truck.
Yes.
So they're going to be on their toes now because it's a lot quieter.
Yeah, but those arms still make a lot of
Yes,
noise,
they
don't
do.
they?
They do.
All right, so we'll hear it coming rumbling down the alley eventually,
Yes,
right?
yes.
Well, congratulations. It sounds like it's a good, and they're more ahead, correct?
That's
This
correct.
is a ramped up
This is
project.
a ramped up process, and we hopefully, within by 2016, 2017, we could have 90% of our garbage trucks fueled by compressed natural gas.
Very good. Well, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank
We appreciate
you.
it.